M1 Global presents.
Okay, fighters, know the rules. Listen to my commands all the time. When I say stop, we stop. Touch those. Go back to your corners.
Judge, ready.
Kurban Ali up to Salamov versus Timur Nagibin, and the first round is underway. Up to Salamov from Dagestan in Russia, a region that produced more than one world-class MMA fighter in the past. And up to Salamov looking to join the ranks.
Abdul Salamov with his hands really high above his eyes. See how high they are, they're going up onto his head.
Yeah, definitely very cautious in the stand-up department. Wants to take this fight to the ground. Dagestani fighters usually strong in the wrestling department.
Well, I've had the pleasure of commentating on Nagibin before, and he's quite aggressive when he starts. Stocky, strong build, throws his punches in bunches.
Nagibin trains with Russian superstar Alexander Shlemenko, but now Nagibin on his back here.
Abdul Salimov was fast. As soon as he saw the punches, he just shot underneath them.
And as I said, strong wrestling displayed here by the Dagestani fighter, pushing Nagibin against the ropes.
Nagibin doing well to get back to his feet while he's on one knee. He looks calm.
Abdul Salamov is tough, and he's unbeaten since four fights, all of them here at M1. On the biggest stage there is in Eastern Europe, so hats off to him. Nagibin trying to get up, and he does.
He does well. Gets the underhook as well.
Goes again, but manages to land on top.
Well, Abdul Salamov went for a sacrifice throw, and it nearly ended up in a bad position for him, but they're both back to the feet now. He's got a hold of that body lock, and he doesn't want to let go.
Great wrestling is played by both of these fighters. Up to Salimov now, attacking the inside of Nagibin's thigh with short knee strikes.
Action.
Nagibin has lost his MMA debut in 2013 and then went unbeaten for 7 straight fights until he lost his last fight in September against Alexei Nevzorov.
Oh, nice. The broke off lovely on the angle. And this is where the aggressive Nagibin comes from.
Yeah, and now he loses up a bit.
That was beautiful!
Could this be the finish for Nagibin here? He has Abdul Salamov on the ground, but Abdul Salamov trying to recover here, pulling guard immediately.
Nagibin could do with standing back up. I know he's got a good ground game, but... Oh, that's a big left hand!
Hard shot from the top.
And again, wow!
Defend yourself, good
luck! Abdul Salamov just coming up! He's in trouble right now! Nagibin passes.
Abdul Salamov desperately tried for the single leg.
Nagibin not rushing anything. Look how calm he's. A lot of people would just rush in after those big shots.
Yeah, and Abdul Salamov still got to be rocked after those hard shots that he took here by Timur Nagibin, who still has well over 1 minute to go in this round to finish the fight early.
Well, I thought Nagibin would have stood back because he rocked him beautifully with that right hand.
That would have been the right thing to do, Ian, but he lands big shots as well here on the ground. And another left by Nagibin. But Abdul Salamov seems to have his composure back right now, but now he has to stand up, and this is bad for Abdul Salamov. Still looking wobbly on his feet here.
Oh, again the right hand and the left hook. Abdul Salimov swinging for the fences.
In pure desperation.
Desperation, you're right, Mark.
Glitching up on the ropes here. Nagibin needs to defend that takedown.
Abdusalamov does not want to trade now with Nagyben.
Yeah, it looks almost like Abdusalamov is just catching a breath here. Not doing much, but he needs to be more active, otherwise they will get separated again.
Gonna be saved by the bell, I think.
Big round for Nagyben in the books. Caught Abdusalamov with a crushing right hand and sent him to the canvas, and you're absolutely right, Ian. I think it would have been the right thing to do to wave him back up and keep the thing standing, because this way he gave Abdusalamov the time to recover, and this is exactly what the tough and durable Dagestani fighter did here. Here's some highlights on the first round. That throw almost backfired on Abdusalamov, who got clipped by a stunning right hand here and ate a lot of follow-up shots on the ground by Nagyben. Wow. Big left hand from the Russian. Abdusalamov extremely durable here in his first round, but a big round for Nagyben. Let's see how Abdusalamov recovered. Still looks a bit wobbly, if you ask me.
Back. Guys, back.
Well,
back.
If I was a betting man, Abdusalamov will go for back. The takedown here.
Back. Yeah.
Ready. Fight.
But Nagyben knows that as well and can prepare for it.
Well, he's still trading with him. And
there's
the
takedown.
He gets it.
And he has Nagyben on the ropes again, which makes it hard for him to get up. Trying to use the ropes here, but it doesn't work.
Trying to pull the hips out and get them flat, but Nagyben using the hand to get back up or to keep himself postured. Now he's on his knee. Next step is to his foot. Now he's got the underhook, which will be harder to take him down. Going to go for the throw. Oh, Nagyben grabs the ropes, but the referee pulls it off.
Don't grab.
Well, he's had his warning there. He said don't grab. Does it again. He could get a point. Deducted.
Again, that throwing attempt backfired for Abdusalamov. And now Nagyben's in his guard. Working the ground and pound here. Nice left slid through.
Oh, and
another
again.
Big left by Nagyben. Open guard now.
I was just about to see the guard wide open if he wants to pass. Now it's closed. Quite content to just throw them big left.
Yeah, and Abdusalamov, he needs to be more active in his guard. Doing basically nothing but holding Nagyben close to his body.
Oh, just missing with that left hand again.
Now the guard's open again.
Wow, what is Abdusalamov? He's on his back, but he's not trying to protect from any of those punches. Every single shot is getting through. Learning how to grapple in MMA is not just learning how to avoid submissions or give submissions. It's learning how to avoid big shots like that.
Yeah, he made a few critical mistakes in this fight, starting with his throws that backfired several times. And now that bad defense from his back. Nagyben doesn't even want to pass the guard of Abdusalamov. Why should he?
He's not in any trouble. Not in any trouble whatsoever. Abdusalamov is not trying any submissions. He's not trying any sweeps. He can't really defend those big punches. So Nagyben is just happy to stay there.
Yeah, Nagyben slamming left after left from the guard here. This is looking to be another big round.
Now the right hands are coming in
for Timur Nagyben.
Oh, Shan again. There's just no defence for them punches.
Nagybin was a bit too tentative in his last fight against Alexei Navzarov. He said he learned from that mistake. He said Navzarov didn't win that fight. I lost it and it won't happen again. And he's showing tonight. Very active here from Abdusalamov's guard. Scoring shot after shot, point after point.
Well, he's not in any threat whatsoever, Mark. Now he's going to pass the side. He's in half guard right now. Half guard's a good position for ground and pound also, but Abdusalamov gets him back into full guard. Well, that's the most active thing that Abdusalamov's done from his back.
But he needs to protect his face from those punches because that left hand is keeping getting through over and over again. Abdusalamov had his last fight in October 2015, over a year-long stretch.
The trouble that Abdusalamov is having as well is he's resting his head on the canvas. And when you rest your head on the canvas and you get hit, the power of the punch bounces through your head. You should have your head off the canvas so you've got a little bit of a ricochet to take the impact. Well, a clear win round here for Nagybin.
Absolutely right, Ian. And Abdusalamov needs to make something happen in that third round if he wants to turn that thing around here. And he clearly needs to avoid getting put on his back again. He needs to watch his own throws because it was one of his own throws that got him in this position in the first place.
Well, the sacrifice throw is quite a strong throw in Sambo because you can hold on to the gi, and as you throw them, you can turn them quite easily by using the gi. Doing it with somebody who was sweaty with no top on, you kind of throw, you lose your grip.
Especially that late in the fight.
And Nagybin's got good counterbalance also.
Here we see some of those hard shots that Nagybin slid through from the guard over and over that left hand. And you can see here in the replay, it's taking its toll on the face of Gurbanali Abdusalamov.
Where is Zoltov?
Yeah, desperation here in the corner of the Dagestani fighter who really needs to make something happen now.
Come on, out! Out!
Well, Abdusalamov will be thinking, what do I have to do? Because I'm not winning the striking, I'm not winning the ground. The only position he hasn't been is on top.
Yeah, but he had a hard time. You know, reaching the top position because he was able to take down Nagybin time and time again, but Nagybin always stood up or sweeped him. So I don't really believe that he would be able to end up on top in the third or last round of that fight. Now he's throwing long hands here. Abdusalamov is.
Oh, my knee on the way in.
Perfectly timed by Nagybin, but missed nonetheless. Now Abdusalamov's working on the takedown again.
Carbon copy of round two, or the beginning of round two. I like when Nagybin just does this cool and calm. Doesn't look in any stress whatsoever when he's on his back.
No, very calm and collective. And Abdusalamov, in desperation, tries to finish this takedown. Hasn't finished one yet in the whole fight.
Nice whizzer.
And again,
Nagybin needs to get his back off the ropes. That's the only thing that's disadvantaged him right now. Abdusalamov is just pushing him up against the ropes. Nagybin, if he breaks free, needs to circle out and get to the center of the ring.
Yeah, that clinch work won't be enough to win that round or to win that fight. Abdusalamov needs to go for broke here.
Oh, that was a little bit better. He didn't sacrifice, but he turned it. Oh, and again,
now he's able to sweep it.
Well, a little bit more of urgency there from Abdusalamov.
Awesome counter wrestling by Timur Nagibin. And Abdusalamov basically only holding on here.
Oh,
another desperate throw, but again it backfired for him. Nagibin again back in the guard.
Where he knows he's safe. He knows he's not in trouble when he's in the guard.
And we have seen this already, and Nagibin will try to land that left hand, and there it is. There's a right.
Just picking his shots one after the other.
Yeah, and Abdusalamov just looking frustrated right now. Just doesn't know what to do. He's clearly not getting up. No offense whatsoever. No defense as well, for that matter. So clearly a bad position for the Dagestani. 2 minutes to go in that fight. In what looks to be a clear victory for the Alexander Shlomenko prospect, the Timur Nagibin.
Well, Nagibin is not in any urgency. He knows he's definitely two rounds up. This one is just going to clinch the fight for him. He knows he's not in any trouble from the guard. Well, Abdusalamov's head flat to the canvas again. I don't know if he realizes he should never have his head on the canvas. He's just going to take all the impact of every punch.
And he's eating shot after shot to the body, to the head. He hasn't defended a single punch in that fight. I don't know what he's doing with his arms. He's just clinching the arms of Nagibin, getting hit over and over again.
It's one of the reasons I used to love fighting BJJ guys, because they were so stuck on going for submissions from the guard, they left the face wide open. But this is going to another extreme. This is just allowing yourself to be hit.
I don't understand what Abdusalamov is doing right here. This is basic MMA 101. Can he finish the fight?
He's out!
Timur Nagibin wins by stunning knockout! And Abdusalamov is out cold!
That was great refereeing there. Lukasz Wysocki, he's seen his eyes roll in the back of his head. He's seen he was out for a flash second there, and he stepped in. Great refereeing, great stoppage. What a great win for Nagibin.
And Abdusalamov doesn't know where he's at right now. Clearly ate too many shots at the end of that fight. Big knockout victory for this young man, Timur Nagibin. One of the brightest prospects out of Russia, who's back on the winning tracks with this victory tonight. Over a tough but really overmatched Gurbanali Abdusalamov.
Уважаемые поклонники боевых искусств, во-первых, наши аплодисменты Курбанали Абдусаламову и его команде. Аплодируем, он мужественно сражался. Но в этом поединке за 50 секунд до его окончания на пятой минуте третьего раунда техническим нокаутом одержал победу спортсмен команды «Новый поток» Тимур Нагибин, клуб «Боец Россия». Наши аплодисменты, наши поздравления. Курбанали, здоровья и скорейшего возвращения в ринг. Ну а мы, конечно же, благодарим, Тимур, тебя. Во-первых, просили тебя большой передать привет из Череповца. Евгению лично можешь передать привет, он самый ярый болельщик.
Евгению большой привет.
С победой тебя, Тим.
Спасибо большое. Я, ну, предпоследний свой бой проиграл. И, ну, были много ошибок. Но знаете, я хочу одно сказать. Мы команда Нового Дога, мы семья. Если один из нас идет на войну, то все идут на войну. И все мы только что победили, потому что мы семья. Я хочу всех поблагодарить. Своего тренера Александра Шеменко, всех своих друзей, всех своих родных, которые в Тюмени, и всех, кто здесь за меня поболел. Спасибо организации «Новый поток». Спасибо, что вы все время нам помогаете. Это все благодаря вам.
Такой разговорчивый, совсем не устал. Ну, конечно же, дорогие друзья, с такой поддержкой проиграть невозможно. Все вы знаете, что совсем недавно триумфально заокеанский кейдж вернулся на «Шторм». Александр Шлеменко, ему аплодисменты, друзья. Александр, я знаю, что ваш контракт не такой жесткий, в том смысле, что вы можете принимать участие, биться в других промоушенах. Имеем ли мы, можем ли мы надеяться, то, что ваш бой произойдет в России, например, в Москве, и, например, вместе с Лигой M1 Global?
Да, я люблю Лигу M1 Global, тем более я больше еще люблю свою организацию «Новый поток». Это наша семья, и я думаю, теперь у нас все есть, чтобы мы выступали здесь, радовали наших болельщиков, наших земляков. Всем спасибо, друзья. Мы с вами.
Спасибо. Ну и, конечно, дорогие друзья, Андрей Корешков. Он не так, к нашему огромному сожалению, триумфально вернулся из-за океана. Андрей, мы все смотрели твой бой, очень переживали. Бой был замечательный, но вот что-то не случилось в самом финале этого боя. В общем, тебе желаем новых побед, новых свершений. Ты один из самых любимых бойцов в нашей стране. Это правда, тебя поддерживают все. Андрей, что скажешь по поводу сегодняшнего поединка в первую очередь?
Спасибо. Тимур, молодец, очень хорошо выступил, выполнил абсолютно все установки, просто красавец.
Ну и, конечно же, в главном бою вечера, поскольку вы сказали, что «Новый поток» — это одна семья, и мы знаем, что в главном бою вечера сегодня еще один, так сказать, член вашей семьи, Алексей Кунченко, так сказать, один из любимых членов этой семьи. Что скажешь по поводу предстоящего поединка?
Алексей готовился упорно, мы готовились вместе. Я уверен, что он не подведет и покажет очень красивый бой.
Ну ждем, ждем и не сомневаемся в вашей команде. Спасибо, команда «Новый поток». Тимур Нагибин, Александр Шлеменко, Андрей Корешков. Россия! Вперед!